Hello, if you've just joined us, you're watching Consider This. I'm Melissa Idris, with me, Sharad Kutan. The Ministry of Health had announced very early in the fight against the pandemic that Malaysia would take a targeted testing approach so as to use our medical resources optimally. However, this approach has been questioned by some medical practitioners, especially in seeing the success of mass testing in countries like South Korea. In targeted testing, the tests are conducted based on the location of COVID-19 hotspots and for high-risk groups only. One epidemiologist who has supported targeted testing over mass testing is Dr. Nirmala Bhupathi, Public Health Medicine Specialist and Associate Professor of Epidemiology at the Faculty of Medicine in University of Malaya. Dr. Nirmala, hello. Good evening. Thank you so much for coming on the show.
Hi, right. Good evening.
So, you know, the WHO, their key message has always been test, test, test. But you wrote an opinion piece that argued that targeted testing is actually better for Malaysia compared to mass testing. Can you help us understand why you argue that?
Well, one of the reasons why I said that in my opinion piece was because test, test, test implies that we are going to cast our net wide. And for a country like Malaysia, testing is expensive to begin with, even for high-income countries. And when we are going out with the approach of test, 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 and cast a wide net, it's going to be really expensive. It's going to be a very expensive affair. And at that point when I was saying about, you know, we can't go that way, one is we are talking about the cost, but also our testing capacity. We were kind of limited, so we have to be very wise and choose what we can do rather than going along with the mainstream of people, because all that really depends on the resource level of the country.
Okay. Nirmala, considering the WHO has as its remit the entire world, developing countries, advanced countries in terms of their economies, why do you think they insist on this one-size-fits-all type of approach? Surely they're aware of the different capacities of the countries around the world.
Yes, it's true. It all started with this mantra that WHO was rolling out of this test, test, test. And it was really like something that quickly picked up and everybody was starting to use the mantra. Mm-hmm. But the problem is that when we are talking about mass testing, and a lot of times we like to refer to South Korea, but when we say mass testing means we are testing a lot of people, testing people whether they, irrespective of whether they have risk or not. And a single point, and then we also talk about testing, and when we talk about testing, really, it's about a single point time testing. And a single test will not be useful, if you think about it, because, yes, we can pick up people who are positive, but people who are negative, who are tested negative, they are labeled as not having the infection. But at any point, they can get infected from the community. So what we are doing is counterintuitive, you know, if you think about, you know, the bigger picture. So even in South Korea, so in order for us to say test, 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 what it really means is if we really, truly want to go along that path, it must be repeated testing. So we test a population, and from time to time, we test them again and again to make sure that there is no new infection, because people live and they move around. So although they may test negative a single point of time, they can move to another place and come back infected. And if we only do a wide single point of testing, we are going to miss this new infection in people who have tested negative previously. Okay. So this is why I think that if we want to go along the road of mass testing, and if we have the money, we have the resources, then it should be repeated testing. So that's, again, it's not something that we can do. It's not pragmatic for a country like Malaysia.
Okay, all right. So with mass testing, you're saying it needs to be repeated testing, not just a single point time testing. But the approach that Malaysia has taken in terms of targeted testing, the question is whether we're testing those targeted cases, that there are enough tests. Last week, I believe the Ministry of Health said that they had achieved initial targets, a test of about 16,000 odd cases, tests per day. They're seeking to step up the testing capacity to 22,000 by next week. That is what they're hoping to achieve. Now, is that enough for targeted testing?
We are heading the right way. We are heading the right way because what we have done in the past, of course, in the early part of the pandemic in Malaysia, we were quite restrictive with our criteria. So in that era, when we were restrictive, we were missing some cases. But right now, apart from increasing the testing capacities, we are also loosening up our criteria. So we are becoming more inclusive. So which means that in the past, we wanted people to have a travel history. We wanted them to have a contact with the person who is positive. So right now, we are also relaxing this. So along with that increasing capacity and loosening so that we are casting our net a bit wider, I think we are heading the right path.
One of the questions I think that comes to mind often is the way in which the public understands the numbers that are trotted out on almost a daily basis. Yeah. One of them has to do with infection rates, right? So how many people are infected? But isn't that also a function of how many tests you roll out? The more tests you roll out, chances are you'll find more people at least positive with the COVID, not necessarily symptomatic. So should we take the numbers of infections seriously? Should that be a criterion for how we dial down or dial up the MCO?
I will split that question into two, right? So first, we are talking about when we look at the number of cases, are we really talking about the real number of cases or are we really reflecting our testing capacity? So you were spot on when you said, you know, for example, when people talk about comparing Malaysia versus our neighbour Singapore, and we see that Singapore has been reporting a lot of, you know, a massive increase in number of cases, it directly relates to their testing because they have stepped up testing and we have not caught up with them. So if we were to test as vigorously as Singapore, we will have higher number of cases. But that is not really what we want to do because it's not just about identifying cases. Because what we really would want to do is identifying those with moderate to severe infections so that they can be treated appropriately so that we can bring down our number of deaths, for instance. So it cannot be tied directly to number of cases. And then going back to your question, I believe you asked whether, I just want to confirm, you asked whether we can link testing capacity with lifting of MCO, is that right?
Yeah, the infection rate with the lifting of the MCO.
Okay, infection rate, that's treading on dangerous waters, right? Because what we are doing is, I think the message here that I would like to clearly, you know, stress out is we should not just rely on testing and positive rates to lift MCO. There are a lot of other factors that we need to look at, you know, like, so in the beginning, we executed the MCO, and the reason was we want to delay the spread of the disease and flatten the curve. Yes, we have somewhat reached that point, but right now, it's too soon to lift the MCO. So we cannot just, you know, just for just a short period of time, we see the numbers are coming down, and then we say that, oh, because the number of cases are low, it's time to lift the MCO. I know there are a lot of economic arguments, social arguments, but from an epidemiological point of view, it can be very dangerous. And it's a very tough balancing act to just, you know, like say that we can relate infection rates and quickly think about lifting the MCO. There needs to be other measures that need to be put in place.
All right. Dr. Nirmala, very interesting points there. I'm going to pick up this conversation in just a couple of minutes. We're going to take a quick break, but stay tuned to consider this as we continue our conversation about Malaysia's testing approach in just a few minutes. We'll be right back.